All right. Advent of Code Day 16 is about to start. So what do we got? We are doing a register machine. Okay. Seems to have a large number of instructions. Interesting. Weird problem. Opcode. Okay. Thank you. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Interesting. Okay, so what's going on here? So we have this two-part thing. Okay, so we have this register machine with these various instructions. So the first thing that we need to do is implement the instructions. So I have written this handy helper function, which takes a function basically from the before registers in the inputs and turns it into a the inputs x and y. Sorry, but each instruction has the opcode and two inputs and an output. So do command takes a function that takes the registers and the two inputs and returns the value that should be put in the output. And then it transforms that into a function that takes the before registers in the instruction and returns the after registers. So we just make a copy of the before registers, we compute the output, and we stick it in the input, and then we return the after registers. And then we return that function, right? That's actually a function that takes the registers in the command to a new set of registers. So with that, we can implement all of the instructions, right? So add, the way that it computes its output is it looks up x in the register and it looks up y in the register and it adds them together. The way that add I computes its output is it looks up x in the register and treats y just as a value. Same thing for mul, same thing for bitwise and, same thing for bitwise or. Set, same thing, even simpler because it just ignores y. And then the comparisons are all similar, I guess, right? So comparing an intermediate to a register, we treat x as a value and we look up y in the registers and we use greater than. So yeah, implementing instructions is relatively straightforward. So now we make a list of all of the instructions. I forgot about mul the first time, but part one was fine anyway. And now we're going to need to figure out which one is which. So we're going to keep a track of, for each opcode, which commands it might correspond to. So initially, each opcode could be any of the commands. So the list is the 16 possible commands. And now we are going to use the samples to figure out which opcode is which. So reading in each of the sort of traces that we get is four lines long, these three lines and then a blank line. So we read the input in sort of groups of four. So if we have a sample line, then sort of parse all the lines. There's this nice regex that someone used on an earlier day that I learned. Sort of parse out the integers from a line. So that's what's happening. So in fact, we want to parse all the lines the same. And in part one, we want to count how many matches we got. And in part two, we want to filter the options for that particular opcode based on this sample. So we only keep the opcodes, but we only keep the commands that are consistent with that trace. That is, if we actually apply that function with these inputs and outputs to the set of before registers, we get the after register. And similarly, for computing sort of the number of matches, right, we just count. This could also be a loose comprehension, but whatever, it's fine like this. So we just loop through all the commands, and we check if that command is consistent with sample, and if so, it's a match, and if we get three matches, then that increases the part one answer by one. Okay, so that's part one, right there. And for part two, so first we need to, so this is actually interestingly not sufficient. The samples they gave us are not sufficient to get down to one opcode per, or one command per opcode. We have to do a little bit more work, which is, so we're just gonna loop through a bunch of times. And if we have sort of finalized an opcode, then we can eliminate it from the lists of all of the other sorry, for a given opcode, if we know what command it corresponds to, that command can't correspond to any other opcode, right? We're looking for like each opcode corresponds to exactly one command. So we can eliminate that command from the list of all the other opcodes, which is what's happening here. It's almost like solving a Sudoku puzzle or something. So if this code is done, then for each other code, we can eliminate that command from this list. So that's the point of enumerate here, which gives us indexes to go along with the commands so that we can compare indexes. I'm not sure if comparing Python functions works, but it seems simpler to compare indices. So here I just have code to print out which command corresponds to which opcode, and like verify that we actually got down to one. And then we just run the program, which is actually quite straightforward now that we've done all this work. Although I had trouble copy-pasting it, which was annoying. Anyway, it says that we start with all zeros in the registers. Yes, that's where it says. And so then for each command in the program, which I've separated out to a separate import file, we can just grab the instruction and we can apply the command. So specifically, right now that we have, this is the index function pair that we narrowed it down to, and this is the actual function on that. And that function takes registers and a line instruction line and returns the new registers, which is exactly what we want. And then after we've run all the commands, we just print out the value of the first register. So yeah, now we have it down to a program that prints out the answer for part one, 651, and then the answer for part two, 706. So that's it.